Hello guys, welcome to another video. Today we are going to make this SVG animation with text. As you can see that this nice little animation is looking very much good, and we can achieve this effect with some little CSS. And in this short video I will show you how you can achieve this effect with CSS, and let's see how we can make it. So as you can see that here is my HTML and here is my CSS file. So in the HTML file, let's create a boilerplate, and here let's give it a title, and the title will be SVG text animation. And in the body, let's create a div with a class of container, and here let's also create another div with a class of SVG text. And in this div, let's have a SVG. So here in the SVG, let's create a symbol. So symbol tag, and here in the symbol let's give it a ID of text, and in the symbol let's create our text. So text tag, and here what we will have is, first of all we will have some parameters. First one is the text and core, and it will be middle. And next one is the x property, for it will be 50%, and next one also y, for it we will use 50%, and that's xy. And in the text, what we will have is, we will write web cipher for the text, and after the symbol let's create use, and here what we will have is our href. And here let's give it an ID of text, and that's all for the HTML. And if I open it with our live server, and here as you can see that here is our HTML and here is our text. So first of all, here what I can do is, let's link our style sheet. So style.css, and in the style.css, first of all let's remove all the unexpected gaps. So padding will be 0 and also margin will be 0, and box sizing border box, and it will remove all the unexpected gap. And here in the container, first of all let's give it a height of 100 vh and width of 100%, and background color will be black, not black for now, let's give it a black. And also here let's set display flex and align items center and justify content center. Now we can't see it because we have a black background. So let's come here and say in the SVG, what we need is, we need to say that fill will be white. Now we can see our SVG, as you can see that here. So it's looking fine, as you can see that. So for now, what I need is, in the style.css, after the fill, let's give it a stroke. Let's say a stroke will be white, and I need a stroke width also. Let's give it a 1 of a stroke width, 1 pixel, and we can't see the stroke width. For that, we need to fill transparent. So change the fill into the transparent. Now we can see that we have this fill. We can't see it properly because we need some bigger font. Let's say font size will be 50 pixel or higher than that. Now you can see that we have a stroke and we have also this transparent fill color. So that's looking fine, as you can see that. Also we can have some letter spacing. So here, let's say letter spacing will be 2-3 pixel, and that's looking fine. So what I need now is, after that, let's come to the stroke joint. So a stroke line join, as you can see that if you come here and if I give it some zoom, you can see that in the line join of the stroke, you can see that it's sharp. So if we need, we can make it round. So for that, let's come here and say stroke line join and give it a round. Now you can notice, if you come here, you can see that there are a round joint in the line join in the stroke, if you can notice rarely. So that's what it does. So after that, let's come to the stroke dash array, which we will animate. So in the stroke dash array, I will use 0 and 100%, and it will remove all the text. And if I come here and inspect, let me make it bigger. So in the inspect, in the div container svg text and svg, here in the svg, if I come here and if you can notice that we gave it a stroke dash array of 0 to 100%, and if I increase the number, as you can see that will be our animation. So in the animation, we will increase the number, and as you can see that it's working perfectly fine. So for now, we need to make it 0, and in later in the animation, we will increase the number of a stroke dash array, and which will animate the text. So that's it, that's the idea. So for now, 0 is fine. So after that, let's come to the keyframes and make our animation. So keyframes, let's say that text animation, and here in the 0%, let's say that stroke dash array, and give it our initial value. And also after that, in the, let's say 100%, also let's say that stroke dash array will be 120%. And if I save it, and in the svg, let's apply the animation. So let's say that animation, the animation name is text animation, and it will be a 2-second animation, and timing function will be linear, and it will go forwards, and that's it. If I save now, you can see the animation. If I refresh, so that's looking perfectly fine, as you can see. So after that, let's give it a fill color when the animation finished. So for that, what we can do is, we can come here and in say 98%, we will have our same stroke dash array, and after that, let's have a fill will be transparent here, and after 98% fill will be white. So when it will come to 100%, the fill color will be white. So that's will look fine, as you can see that in the animation. So let me zoom it, and here, and you can change any font size and font color and anything as you want in the svg. As you can see that we used font family, let's give it a different font family so that we have different style. So So let's come to the fonts.googles.com, and here let's say that I want this font, which is come here, and as you can see that we select that, and let's import it. And in our style sheet, let's place it in the top, and in the here let's copy the font family and come here in the SVG. What we can do is we can paste it, and if I paste it, you can see that our font is now changed. So let me zoom out and set it, and if I refresh, now we can see that we have this little thing going on. Let's come here in the SVG and give it a width of 800 pixel, and that will perfectly fine. Sorry, 800%, not 800%, it will be pixel. So as you can see that it's looking fine. If I give it another font family, and that's it. So you can use any kind of font family. So let's use another font family and see how it looks. Let's use this one. This fancy font family. So let's add this font family, as you can see that. So let's select that and remove our previous one and copy that and replace it here and copy the font family and also replace the font family with the previous one. And here if I save, now we will have our this font family, as you can see that. So as you can see that it's looking fine. So you can achieve many kind of font family and effects with the CSS. And let's say I want a font decoration, sorry, text decoration, underline. So that's also looking not fat. So that's up to you how you want it. Let's also say that font style will be, let's say, italic. And as you can see that now our font is italic. So that's it guys. We can achieve this animation with a little line of CSS. And if you like this video, please give it a thumbs up, and don't forget to subscribe the channel if you want more this kind of video. And my name is Arfan, and I will see you in the next video.